Our game is taking shape. The gameplay is pretty much finished. Now it's time to polish our game and get it ready to build. Next, we're going to be adding audio, sound effects, and music. There are three main audio components in Unity. There are audio clips, audio sources, and the audio listener. We will concentrate on audio clips and audio sources. For more details on these three audio components, please see the information linked below. Audio clips hold our audio data or sound files. Audio sources play our audio clips in the scene. Let's find our audio clips. In Assets, we have an audio folder. Here we can see a selection of sound effects and a music track. If we select any one of the audio clips, we will see that clip's import settings in the inspector. The preview window will display additional information about that clip. If the preview window has been closed, we can drag the preview window's header bar up to reopen it. In the preview window, we can see the audio clip's waveform, we can play or loop the audio clip's audio file, and we get additional information about that audio clip printed at the bottom. We won't cover the details of the audio importer. For more information on the audio importer, please see the links below. We do want to note one important import setting here, however, and that is 3D sound. For our game, we want to make sure all of our audio clips have 3D sound deselected. This should already be set properly on the assets provided with this project. When an audio clip is imported as a 3D sound, Unity will compare the location of the audio source playing the audio clip and compare it with the scene's one active audio listener, and use the relative positions to affect the clip's volume and panning. We don't want any of this working in our simple arcade-style game, so we want to make sure 3D sound has been deselected. The audio files that we have in this project are three styles of explosions, asteroid, enemy, and player, a background music track, and two weapons effects. In this portion of the space shooter project, we will be ignoring the enemy sounds. They are for later optional assignments. We need to associate an audio clip with our explosion prefabs and our player ship. The explosions need to play their audio clip when they are first instantiated into the scene. The player ship, on the other hand, needs to play its audio clip when the player fires their weapons. We associate an audio clip with a game object by using an audio source component. The audio source plays an audio clip. We could add an audio source component to our game objects, and then reference an audio clip for that source to play. But there is an easier way to do this. If we drag an audio clip onto a game object, Unity will create a new audio source on the game object and automatically reference the dragged audio clip. Let's see this in action. We can drag assets easily from our project view onto game objects in our hierarchy. To drag an asset, like our audio clip, onto a prefab asset, which both are in our project, we can either open two project view windows, or we can change our existing project view from using the two-column layout to using a single-column layout. This will allow us to drag objects from one part of our project view to another without losing focus on our target asset. Our first target asset will be the asteroid explosion prefab. Our asteroid hazards have a reference to this prefab. When we destroy the asteroid will spawn this prefab. At that point, we want it to go bang. With the explosion asteroid prefab selected, drag the explosion asteroid audio clip onto the game object in the inspector and drop it. We can see that Unity has added an audio source to the prefab asset, and that audio source has a reference to the audio clip that we dragged and dropped on it. the bulk of the component is dedicated to 3D sound settings, which we can safely ignore. The only important setting that we need to worry about for our game here is Play on Awake. Play on Awake should be on by default. For our explosions to work properly in our game, we need to make sure that it is set on. This way, the audio will play automatically when we spawn our explosion. We can also drag an audio clip onto a prefab asset without having it visible in the inspector. Select the Explosion Player audio clip and drag it onto the Explosion Player prefab asset. As we are using the defaults as they are, with Play on Awake automatically set, we don't need to make any changes to this at all. Now the player's weapon sound is almost as simple. Select the Weapon Player audio clip and drag it into the scene view and drop it onto the player game object. Again, we can see that Unity has added an audio source to the player game object, and the audio clip reference is set to Weapon Player. The player, however, has just a few more items to consider. First, we definitely do not want Play on Awake set. Otherwise, we would get our weapon sound playing on the very first frame of the game. Deselect Play on Awake. Now, if we won't be playing this sound automatically, how will we play it? We must do this from our player controller script. So select the player controller script and open it for editing. Looking at our player controller script, where do we want to write our code? In our update function where we fire our shot. As all of the logic will be executed within the same frame. Practically, it doesn't make a difference where in the block we write our new line, as long as it is inside the if statement controlling when we fire our weapons. We will add this line of code to the end of this block. Write audio.play with a capital P followed by parentheses. Audio is the shorthand reference that this script will use to talk to the audio source attached to it. And play is a function on the audio source that will play the current clip, and as a function needs to be called with the parentheses. It is worth noting that we can change the clips to be played and other additional functionality all in code, but we won't be covering that here. For more information on the audio source or any of the other audio components, please see the details linked below. Now, when we fire our weapon, we instantiate our shot clone and play our weapon sound. Save this script, return to Unity, save the scene, and enter play mode. And we have sound effects. Exit play mode. Along with our sound effects, we also have a background music track. We can find this in our audio folder as Music Background. Let's put this background music on our game controller. This audio track will be self-sufficient and won't need to interact with the game controller at all. It could go on its own game object. But the game controller's game object is a tidy place to keep a component that is related to the game in general. Drag Music Background into our scene view and drop it on Game Controller. This will add a new audio source to Game Controller, with Music Background as the referenced clip. We want this music to start right away, and play during the entire game. For this, we want to make sure that Play on Awake is selected, so it will begin playing on the first frame, and select Loop as well, so the audio runs continuously. The audio clip is designed as a seamless loop, so there will be no audible gap when the music continuously restarts. Save the scene and enter play mode. Now we have sound effects and music. Exit play mode. The last step we need to take is balancing the audio, all of the clips are currently being played back at full volume, and they don't mix well. Let's bring some of these effects down in volume. Select the player game object and bring up the audio source component. Change the volume property to 0.5. This will reduce the strength of the player's weapon sound. Next, select the game controller game object, and again, on the audio component, reduce the volume property to 0.5. Save the scene and enter play mode. Now the explosions are still bright and snappy, but the player's weapons and the background music are not so overwhelming. Excellent. In the next assignment, we will see how to display a score.